At the end of this media, you would have learned how to troubleshoot closing control scheme of a circuit breaker. Let us take the circuit for local mode of closing the breaker for troubleshooting. Troubleshooting of the scheme starts from supply lines. Before starting the process, the closing coil of the breaker must be isolated electrically. This is because when the closing command is given, the closing coil 52C gets energized in fraction of second. The closing coil is usually short time rated, that is, it is designed to withstand supply for fraction of second only. While troubleshooting, there is a possibility for the closing coil to be in energized condition for long time. For example, if anti-pumping relay is not healthy or if there is some other internal problem before tracing the fault, closing coil may get damaged. Thus, it is always safe to isolate the closing coil from the circuit which has supply while troubleshooting. Consider the supply voltage is 220 volt DC. Measure the voltage between K1 and K2 lines and check for the supply. Check whether the fuses are healthy. To find fuses unhealthy condition, measure the resistance across the fuses with multimeter kept in low resistance range. If the multimeter is kept in high resistance range for checking the fuse condition, and if there is small resistance across the fuse due to melting, then also the multimeter will show 0 ohm only. That is why the multimeter should be kept in low resistance range and check for 0 ohm across the fuses. In some cases of defective high rupturing capacity HRC fuses, the resistance across the fuse will be more. By using multimeter, resistance should be measured and fuse should be replaced if required. Assume that all fuses are found normal. The L by R switch should be checked for healthiness. The L by R switch contacts may be pitted or wires may be burned due to local heating. The healthiness of the L by R switch is found by measuring the voltage between K23 and K2 lines. If the switch is normal, then no voltage drop takes place across the switch. Hence, the multimeter shows full supply value. If the switch is not healthy, voltage drops across the switch and so multimeter shows less value than supply voltage. From that, you can identify and rectify the problem in the switch. Assume that the L by R switch is found healthy. Next, TNC switch should be checked for healthiness. It is done by turning the switch to closed position momentarily and measuring the voltage between K211 and K2 line. If the switch is healthy, multimeter displays the full supply voltage. Multimeter shows voltage less than that of supply when the switch is not healthy. Assume that TNC switch is found normal. Anti-pumping relay 95 and its contact 95-1 must be now checked for healthiness. Apply voltage to the coil by turning the TNC switch to closed position momentarily and check the relay pickup. If the relay coil 95 is found healthy, check its contact 95-1. Measure the voltage between K17 and K2 lines. If the contact is damaged or pitted, voltage drops across it. Hence, the multimeter shows voltage less than that of supply voltage. Assume that anti-pumping relay and its contact are found normal. The limit switch should be checked for healthiness. This is done by checking for the full supply voltage between K15 and K2 lines. If the limit switch is found good, the contact 52B should be checked for healthiness similar to 95-1 contact. If the contact 52B is found good, reconnect the closing coil and check its operation by turning the TNC switch to close position, and still if the relay is not picking up, replace the coil. Thus, troubleshooting of closing control scheme of the circuit breaker is learnt.